customarily, when a sister dies in the house, we would prepare the body of the sister, like do the last offices, you know, the washing up of the body, the plugging of the all the orifices, and then prepare, you know, close the eyes and dress the sisters up comfortably in their best religious outfits, you know. I remember very well when Sister Koda was dying. When I got to the into Sister Koda's room, she just took the last gasp. And I was like, as I said, oh my, she's gone. That's what I said. Just to straighten the Sister Koda's body and then close her eyes with a cotton wool and just then cover her with the bed sheet. And an hour later, now when we're like preparing for the mortuary, I took out her dress and then I just remembered, because the previous week we were dealing with Sister Celine's preparation for the burial. So I went to this mortuary, Dove's here in Mthatha, and they were explaining the protocols since COVID burials. They say whether a person is COVID or not, they're not dressed up. We're breaking now all the customs that we used to do. And then what happens is that the undertaker, when they come on site, they would then wrap the sister with a blanket and then take off the body. To see that nakedness, that helplessness, that we used to do this, you know, to treat our sisters some more or less with this dignity, to give them this last dignity. But now here COVID has stripped us of, you know, this kind of human dignity. You just left our sisters, their corpses, their dead bodies were lying there, uncovered. I think that was very traumatic, and I faced it unprepared. So I looked at that cross, and the more I looked, I just saw nakedness. I saw the helplessness of Jesus, and I could see it in our sisters' dead bodies, lifeless bodies.